If you haven't got one, just put your hand up and we'll get them to you. We're going to take communion at the in a minute. What? Oh dear. So I had prepared a 50-minute sermon on multiculturalism, and then found out that the kids are in, and it contained a not appropriate story for children. So another day perhaps. So I've had to change it. So I've only got one page. I've probably only got about 300 words, and most of those are Bible verses. But that's all right. Yeah, amen. Right, absolutely. What did I see yesterday? Something about if your sermon, preach, whatever you talk, whatever you want to call it, has got more personal stories than Bible verses, you might need to reevaluate. Mine didn't, but it's a good thing to think, right? It's good because this is powerful. This book is powerful. It's the Word of God. It's living. It's active. Amen. Amen. So I changed my opening line, by the way. It's now the second line. Jesus' love transcends every culture, colour and nation. This would have been my opening line. Jesus is not a white man. Jesus is not a black man. Billy Graham says, he came from that part of the world that touches Africa and Asia and Europe. Christianity is not a white man's religion. And don't let anybody ever tell you that it's white or black. Christ belongs to all people. He belongs to the whole world. Amen? So I've got a few Bible verses. We're going to go to Matthew chapter 9, verse 9. You may wonder what this has to do with International Sunday. There is a thread, I promise. As Jesus passed on from there, he saw a man called Matthew sitting at the tax booth, and he said to him, "Follow me." And he rose and he followed him. And as Jesus reclined at the table in the house, behold, many tax collectors and sinners came, and they were reclining with Jesus and his disciples. And when the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" But when he heard it, he said, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy, not sacrifice, for I came not to call the righteous, but sinners." It's a great passage, a great story in and of itself. But the key for us this morning is the fact that Matthew was a tax collector. How many of you are friends with a tax collector? Right, they're not great people. Let's be honest. But here we see Jesus hanging around with many tax collectors and sinners. The outcasts, the rejects, the people that we don't want to associate with. Not only that, but verse 10, Jesus reclined at the table. He was clearly comfortable in their company. He's relaxing with them in their presence. Let's go to Luke chapter 5, verse 12. While he was in one of the cities, there came a man full of leprosy. And when he saw Jesus, he